begin so much? Where to begin? Okay, so I guess we'll start with lucid dreaming, astral projection experiences, and then we'll go into deja vu, precognition, future seeing, and other demonstrations of psychic abilities. So yeah, enjoy. So, first, lucid dreaming and stuff, and deja vu, and future seeing, is an experience I had. I had precognition in a dream that was lucid, very vivid, of the movie theaters. And then this morning, my mom and my sister went to the movie theaters. And I had no idea that they were going to do that. To go watch a movie. And then the shadow memories, if you focus on your forehead, it will help trigger it and stuff. But sometimes it's hard to remember, but I finally remembered, thanks for triggering it. And I astral traveled at school, and I changed, and I forgot my combination. I never knew it, and numbers are, like, really hard to understand, and they change all the time in the astral realm. So I just went through the locker, and I grabbed clothes that I don't know why I had clothes in there, but thoughts create reality, and it just created it. And I forgot the combo, and everyone around me was, like, frozen like mannequins and stuff. So that was one experience. And then another one was at school on a table. I usually plank in the air on my entire body. I was like a push-up with no legs on the floor. And I kept sinking through the dang table. And someone challenged me, said I couldn't do it. And I couldn't, and usually I could. And then I was lost, walking in the dark, and I finally found a car, and I opened the hood of it, and I found the coil wire, which is red, and then I ran the wire from the positive side of the battery to the red coil wire. Then I cranked the engine, seeing the small wire and cable of the battery. I crossed the two with my finger, which I formed as a screwdriver. Then I unlocked the steering wheel and drove fast and recklessly to King Supers. Or this is where it gets weird. Where everything got weird, I kept feeling a cup of water over and over again, trying to make Ormus when I had the cup I needed in my other hand. And so, like, it was so weird. And then now for another experience, I was fighting. One thing I like about lucid dreaming and astral projection, it's so vivid and you remember it, and you can still recall that, what's it called? Body memory or muscle memory. And I can, like, fight and train my martial arts and kung fu to get even better with the law of attraction and stuff like that. Anyways, I was fighting, doing my martial arts in a cage. This happened again during sleep or lucidity. My body had rushes. This keeps happening recently. I have rushes of energy being absorbed throughout my entire body. I think of it. I enjoy it, and I get filled with it. My body twitches, shakes, and I wake up continuing to shake and twitch, kind of like a seizure. I think this is from training psychic abilities and stimulating my astral body energy, etc. Also went to a reality check, and my nose, this was weird. My nose was one whole nose, and I had one hole, and it was like one nostril. And I could fit two fingers, like, it was so weird. And then, usually, I could, like, I pinched it, and I could still breathe, right? As if I was underwater and still could breathe. But it was, like, one big hole. And then, I was getting ready to wake up, and I usually stretch in my bed before, like, Qigong exercises, before I start moving around. And I had a false awakening, and I loosened my body. I stretched my ankles, I got up, stretched my neck, then I was back lying down instantly. But this time, physically, I was really, really waking up and stretching. So it's pretty trippy. And then another one, I wrote down this experience in the moment once I recalled the shadow memories instantly returning. Holy shit, bro, I heard a beeping sound, and the reason why it returned so quickly, otherwise I would have maintained this experience longer, was because of the movie Insidious and the beeping sound. And thoughts create reality and instantly manifest in the astral realm. So I didn't want to have a negative experience and see some entity or some scary shit. So I'm like, okay, no, I'll just return. So I tried forcing myself to return back into my body. But that didn't work. So I was like, okay, I know what I gotta do. I gotta affirm command myself to return and just let myself return. Don't force it. And I did. It took about 10 seconds, so a while, but it did eventually. So I heard a beeping sound, and I visualized I was on the. This was a. I was visualizing I was on the ground at school, comparing that feeling with my bed, and then I started to spin. My body was spinning. My legs were down, my chest up, and my arms were out of my physical body into the etherical one, and I was moving them. And it was a glossy type vision, and I had a buzzing, vibrating sound in my ears. 5 or 10 seconds later, I wanted to return to my body. It took a while, still spinning, but I declared return and got sucked back in, falling away into a tunnel into my body. Then it took 5 seconds to gain awareness of my physical body. I was in sleep paralysis, so I couldn't move for about 10 seconds. Then I finally got up to type this experience, and this started from a handstand spinning, then onto a ground. And now this is another experience. I just got done doing like an hour or two ago. I was about to separate. 45 minutes into deep meditation, I saw the usual, experienced the usual sensations beforehand. Saw lights forming with my eyes closed. I couldn't move. Sleep paralysis. I was swaying back and forth, loosening my astral body. Then I had a vision, ESP, and psychic abilities, and I knew he was making grilled cheese, and I sensed and saw him coming upstairs to talk to me. He knocked and gave me a sandwich. You're also about to see is I knew it was snow. There was definitely snow present, and the center of attention was something in the center, and they were conversing. Teleportation, ESP, and other psychic abilities, and got it correct.